lovely people, so today we're gonna play with Dragon Beauty. I've got the Dragon Beauty Transformation Face Powder, which is this beautiful thing in pink. Pink and the peach and orange, which should brighten my under eyes. So I've done my base, so I've done my primer, foundation, concealer and powder, and then I'm gonna try this in a second. Then I've got the gorgeous Fantasy Palette Volume 3, which is this gorgeous thing which we're gonna try an eye look with. I've got something in my head I'm gonna use, and then I've got 5 of her matte lipsticks, and I'm gonna use the pink one today because of course it fits with the palette, but I just wanted to show you my Dragon Beauty collection, and that's all that's in there. So yeah, we're gonna play with Dragon Beauty. I hope you enjoy. I can do some swatches, why not? Let's do some swatches from this beautiful palette. Start with the black. Ooh, this feels nice. Pink. Not, but I put my fingers in here. I don't know yet if I've put them in here. And this one. Those are the shades. Let's put them in my hand. Ooh. Me likey likey. Look at that. This came off way more pigment than I even thought. I didn't know what to expect with Dragon Beauty. I think Nikita is quite out there, quite extreme. I don't know, but I like the aesthetic of her brand, and that's why I want to try. I like trying new brands, new things. So yeah. Yeah, so I never tried any Dragon Beauty before, except for this one and her lipsticks that I had for a while. These two are new to me, including, oh, I forgot about it, the Dragon Beauty setting spray, which I have already tried on my own time. Actually, to be honest, I used it for a wedding and it stayed on all night. So I have an evening wedding I had, so that's really amazing. And those shades are really nice, like I said, way more buttery than I thought it would be. So yeah, really nice. That's what we're gonna play with. I'll start with showing you the powder. It's supposed to be brightening if you use both of them, so I'm just gonna get myself my under eye brush, dip in both, and we'll see if it works the way I did powder underneath this. I don't know if I should, or there is a difference between doing this, but I have used this before, and I actually quite enjoy it. But I don't feel like I used it as just as setting powder. Doesn't work that well, but I think you can see the brightening effect. Right? Can you? Yeah, I think you can. So yeah, for the setting spray, this has a fairly heavy smell. So if you don't like smells on your setting spray, don't use it. And it's also a little bit of a perfumated alcoholic smell. So if you don't like that, don't buy it because it's really scented. But it stayed on put all day, so that I liked about it. And the mister is not as fine as the continuous setting mist from Morphe, but it's also not bad. So, and like I said, I had it on for a wedding and it stayed put all day, which I quite appreciate. Oh, yeah. So yeah, if you wanted to know, then setting spray is actually really good. My skin looks nice. So I'm gonna put the rest of my face on and I'll come back to you when we start my eyes. And of course, please, if you like these kind of videos, then subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, give me a comment, give me a like, would be amazing and very much appreciated. I would love it so to have you there. So yeah, so I'll be right back when I'm ready to do the eyeshadows, which look quite nice, if I'm honest. So that's the rest of my face done. I think I've outdone myself a little bit with the blush and the bronzer and contour or anything, but oh well. I haven't done it in ages and I love blush, so oh well, that has to happen. So yeah, I'm gonna go in with my Dragon Beauty Fantasy Paw Volume 3. This pretty little thing, and I had an eye look in my head before, so we're just gonna do that. There is who's the baddest of them all in here, because yeah, she has had a lot of stuff at Bad Bitch and everything. But it is a cover-up, so it has to go. Because it annoys me. I can't live with those things. People that know me know that those things have to go out of my palette. Even though I don't use my mirror. I have a mirror right here that I'll use. And so we're going to start with the blackout... So we're going to start with the blackout color. This is gorgeous. And I love the egg and the fact that it has shells. I'm wondering how long it's going to take to stay like this. But I'm really wondering how the black is. So we're going to try it. No, I want a smaller brush. So I'm going again with my Morphe M507, because I have an idea that I did on a little bit the shape I did late on my life and 31st of September, the last day of September on a Thursday anyways. So I was going to do a little wing on this side so that you can see a little wing. And I don't know why I'm talking, but yeah, I'm talking now, but I will be not talking the rest of my eyes. I just want to play with makeup and I'll do a voiceover. I'll keep this stuff in and do this and then we'll see what I'm going to do and if this all works together and how good this is. But the black looks nice, to be honest. Let's just do a little bit more. Yeah, that's actually quite nice. I think the Huda Black that you saw in my last video was a little bit worse, so yeah, let's go do my eyes in a voiceover so I can watch YouTube and yeah, I can speed everything up. I want to speed up and make a little shorter video, so. So we're gonna just continue with a beautiful black and black out, because this went on so nice. Look at that, go on. I mean, for a eyeshadow that brand that isn't very known, I think, for their eyeshadows. Or is it? I don't know. I've never seen any one of my makeup loving YouTubers that I watch do on the a video on Dragon Beauty, and I was interested. I don't know, they're for some reason really aesthetic pleasing for me. I don't know why. I just need to try it. I want the setting powder as well, and a couple of the lip liners, but and, I'll get there one day. It's just expensive, so I'll be careful. But if I see it like I like this eyeshadow, but look at that black go on. I mean, they're not known for their... Nikita is just known for being out there and extreme and everything, but her makeup brand is not that known here, I think. Or am I wrong? I don't know. That's what I feel. So yeah, that's what I see when I look around the people around me that do makeup. But I was interested in this. I was interested in this palette. Now I want other palettes. Because actually, look at that black go. I mean, I like it. I really do like it. Now we're going to go in with B-Day Bitch. And this is going to be on my Jaclyn Hill brush. New brush set that I bought recently. And look at how that goes on. Look at that bright pink. Whew, that's just yummy. I'm sorry, that's just yummy. I love this. This palette is just nice and good and nice and pink. And I like it. And I actually enjoy it. I really did. When I don't talk, I have a resting bitch face sometimes. So sorry for that. But I really did like it. I really did enjoy it. You can see that in the beginning and the end of the video. For some reason, I'm looking really serious doing my eyeshadow today. But well, it is like it is. I filmed it a while ago. It has to go up now because, yeah. And I have to make new videos. I'm going to film with Milk tonight when I'm doing the voiceover. It's a while after I filmed it. So, but look at that go on. I really like it. I need to use this palette more and do different shapes or different things with it. I don't know. I just really enjoyed it. And I love trying new brands and new stuff and things I haven't tried before. Like I said before this, I only had some of her lipsticks. And I love the packaging of the lipsticks as well, of the liquid lips. And I had the transformation powder already. I don't use it that often because it's just an extra step again. Maybe if I had a party, but because of COVID and everything happening, I don't have that much parties, so yeah. But look at these colors. Look at the bright pink. I love it. I love the bright pink. Going back in with the black. Black out,
and just blending it a little bit more blacky. And then we're going in with Cake, this beautiful light pink, and this again on a Jaclyn Hill brush. You can see what I wrote down to make it easier for you and me. And then blend this around it again. It did fade the pink a little bit because it bent a little bit on top, but yeah. I didn't mind it, it looked really nice. The colors are really like they are in a pan, which excites me. There was not fallout, I think I had to wick away something like once. So that was nice. Yeah, I enjoyed it. It just had 5 colors, but it just worked well together. It worked for me, I like it. I came up with an extreme eye look anyways, even though Nikita is more of a natural eye look kind of girl. Not the rest is natural, but her eye look mostly is. But and I don't think I watch her Instagram a lot because I just think she's extreme and I like to watch it. I don't know, the drama and everything. I don't watch the drama channels on YouTube or anything, but I just like to watch those influencers go crazy on Instagram. I don't know, I think it's funny. And I don't think she ever uses her own palettes, to be really honest. But I like this one, so sorry for the coughing. Yeah, now we're going on with my favorite thing to do, my Pillowies paints, this extra spicy, gorgeous light pink. To cut the crease, because of course we're doing a standard cut crease Sylvia look with just a little deviation by the shape, by the wing to do it, but still a Sylvia look. But I like it. I like my Sylvia look, of course. That's why it's a Sylvia look. Yeah, Pillowies paints are the best. I need all the colors. I will get there one day, maybe. But I want so many brands and so many stuffs and so many collections complete. It's just incredible. It's just weird because I think Nikita has 3 palettes. So, yeah, to complete them, I need all 3, right? But then again, I want to complete all my collections, which is going to cost me a lot of money. And yeah, not a good idea. Just don't do it. So yeah, finished cutting the crease, almost just putting a little bit extra intensity on it because the other eye was a little bit more. So yeah, that's what we're doing. And then we're gonna go in with 6. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm just pronouncing it. And my Jessup 237, of course. And look at that. Look, I just go on with the brush. I love it. Like, you know, I hate using my fingers or something, a silicone brush. I love just using normal brushes. And it just goes on so nicely. Shimmers are so nice, so pretty. Works. I'm impressed with this palette, like you can hear, I think, on my voice. Not on my resting bitch face that I'm using to put my makeup on at the moment, but I really did enjoy using this. And the colors are fab, and I love pink, and I have so many pink palettes I have to try, because the gorgeous Nemesis sent me a Juvia's one and a Colourpop one. And I've got a Hello Kitty from Colourpop one that I got from Missa. And I have to film with all of those still. And I will. I promise. I will with all of those. So going back in with Blackout on a smaller brush this time. This is the GH52 from Morphe and Jaclyn Hill. To make the wing a little bit more intense and around it. I quite like the way it came out with this shape, to be honest. And then we're going in with B-Day Bitch to blend out the shimmer a little bit. To make the shape a little bit nicer. I think that works well. I like that. I like trying new makeup. It's just my Blackout, and it's gonna be underneath my eye. It's gonna be the same brush I just used for the other shades on top. Because, yeah, I just clean it in my color switch and just use it again. Because it's nice and fine, which is nice for the under eyes. You can be in a good place. And then Birthday Bitch is gonna go on again. Yeah, I don't care for the names or anything. I think it's unnecessary. But it's totally Nikita, so. And I do like the aesthetics and the look of these dragon axe-shaped pants. Going with Cake again on the under eye. Because, yeah, we're going to do the same as the top. Because we couldn't do any extreme different color. Because, yeah, that's not in the palette. But I do like a cohesive eye sometimes. Now we're going to go in... following my brush. Now we're going to go in with 21. On the inner corner and my brow bone, This is the GH39 brush from Jaclyn Hill and Morphe. Look at it, that's pretty. I like it. Yep. I like this palette, to be honest. I loved using it, I like it, it looks good. Put a little bit more on, of course. Now we're gonna go in with the lippy, that beautiful pink lip. I did put lip liner on from Beauty Bay, and now we're gonna put this gorgeous lipstick on. Look at that color. These lipsticks are so nice on the lips as well. I really like them. I have two nudes, a brownie and a pinky nude, and then I have a brown and a pink and a red in big. The other ones are minis, but yeah, I don't mind that. I still want the black as well, because she has a black too, if I'm right, so yeah. Yeah, actually, after trying a little bit of her makeup, like I'm doing now, I would like to try more, because it's actually quite nice. It works well, the setting spray is also stinky, but it's really, really good. So yeah, I do really enjoy her products. This lipstick also, it looks so nice, and apparently I have to make weird faces to see if nothing is on my teeth. So here, have fun with that. Yeah, it's nice.
So, that's me done. How do you like it? Ah, the lipstick is nice. I didn't try this lipstick before yet, so I love it, love it, love it. Looks good. I again did that in voiceover as well, because normally you can't talk while doing your lips anyway, so I figured let's do it like that. Oh, wow. And I tried new lashes. This is the Rebel Smoke from Unicorn Cosmetics. This is from my Unicorn Mystery Box that will be up before this one. So you've seen me get that. And I never tried them before, but I actually quite like it with this look. I'm honestly nicely surprised by the eyeshadows. The pink, this pink in the middle was so nice and vibrant. Really good, really bright pink. The lighter one that seduces a little bit. Black is also really nice. I like the shimmers. I actually quite like this palette, to be really honest. Really happy I got it. I wanted it for so long to try more Dragon Beauty. I don't know why, it just intrigues me, and I like trying new products, and these are now at Beauty Bay, so it's easy to get. So, and these were never at Morphe, because I got the first lipsticks and the transformation powder from Morphe, and the last, this one, the lipstick and a new setting spray are from Beauty Bay. So, and Beauty Bay shipped them to me in a long time. If Beauty Bay ever sees this video, please, please make sure that I can order from you again. My orders get cancelled so often. I think in this year I had 2 orders sent to me, and that's it. And last year it just went so easy, and the years before that and everything, but this year sucks. Probably because of Brexit, but still, it so annoys me. Please stop doing that, because it's really annoying. So yeah, but I really like it. Like I said, if you don't like extreme smelling setting sprays, don't buy it. But I think it really works in longevity and everything, to be really honest. I would say for setting spray standards, keeping it on, it's almost as good as my Urban Decay All Nighter. Actually, I think, at least for my skin, because it and the wedding, like I said, I'm doing this at night, I've just finished it, I won't have it on very long, but for the wedding it was so good, so I think this is going to be my longevity setting spray, to be really honest. The smell is strong, so like I said, if you don't like perfume or you're allergic to it, then please don't try it, because it's really perfumated, but for my skin it's actually really nice, and I like it, and it stays on really nice. And the eyes are so vibrant, and the lip is also so nice, and all her lipsticks are nice. It's the 5th lipstick I've got. I all like them all, so to be really honest. So yeah, for me, this is a thumbs up. I really like this. I hope you enjoyed it as well. And if you did, then please subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell. Give me a comment. Give me a like. It would be amazing. If you want to become part of my meets, I have a Patreon set up. The link is down below in the description box. We're going to do a Skype call soon. So yeah, that would be amazing. Could join me, but you don't have to, of course. That's your own choice. I would just say I love you all. Be yourself. Stay confident. I love you. And see you in the next one.